So I wanted to get this video to you as soon as possible because I had a conversation with my buddy Karl Staib, who is right here, and we wanted to chat a bit about this system that he's developed, this framework that I went through with him. This really changed the way that I not only deal with the team members that I'm working with, but also it's actually really made me rethink how I handle myself in the process. So can we talk about what it was like when you and I started to kind of dive into this method or dig into this method, to use a more friendly term? You know, when I said it, you told me about it and you're like, would you like to get involved? I'm like, yeah, let's go through this because I could use this.
This all came about because I think I really struggled with calibrating with myself and with my teammates. And that was the impetus for this. And I found that if you can, on a regular basis, find time to reflect with yourself as well as with the people that you work with and have a framework around it, you're so much more productive. Things are more clear. And it's easier to, you know, have communication that helps you get things done versus you get caught spinning your wheels.
Right. Or just like getting by, right? Like just kind of getting, and that's kind of how I felt. Like I've got so many things that I want to accomplish, right? But I know, what do they say? Like those who want to go fast, go by themselves. Those who want to go further, go together, right? Like that I'm paraphrasing it here, but, and I know I need more people to help get the idea of time crafting and the work I'm doing out there, but I've never been really good at conveying. Like I can delegate with tools and we have all those things. But once you started to talk to me about like, Mike, you need to, I think, look deeper and be willing to be a bit more open with people in terms of like the team members you're bringing on and vulnerable and share some of your values and principles, something I'd never really done before. And I had never really done it in the setting that I did it in with, you know, with my operations coordinator. As soon as I did that, it kind of, it got them on board right away, right? Like it did not feel as like the onboarding, you know, you hear about onboarding and all that stuff. It wasn't as arduous or painful. And I think that's what keeps people from doing that stuff. It's like, oh, we got to bring somebody else on, so on and so forth. But someone's going along with you because you've kind of brought them into the fold in a way that, you know, involves being open, honest, vulnerable. The results have been fantastic.
Yeah, because like you said, like it can feel tedious because you don't really have a plan. It's like, you know, you start anything, you know, what you want to do is every morning is, you know, get the hard stuff done first. And then as your energy wanes, you do the lighter tasks, you know, and you talk about energy and you talk about theming. And the same thing goes with when you work with other people, if you have a process in place, a framework that fits with your personality and you get a better understanding of their personality, that's how you guys calibrate.
Well, I think what's great about Dig to Fly is it turned me more from a manager into a leader. You know what I mean? Like it did involve me kind of stepping back initially. And I want you to share this with everybody watching. The idea of I need to look at myself first. Like I need to go, okay, because it's very easy, you know, to say, well, this is what we do here. And this is like the hard skills stuff, right? Like that, because you often hire for that. But I mean, the thing is that culture is what I really like. I want people to feel warm and welcome inside the culture and to understand why, you know, why does Mike have a themed day for this? Like, what's the point? If they understand that, then it helps them do their work better and also share the mission, the mandate, whatever you want better. But it also, it's not just an edict. It's like, oh, this is a way of operating. This is the way that Mike works. It's the way that we work. What did you do for me? Because I mean, the title of this video is "This System Changed the Way That I Work." Because it did. And most people are like, oh, Mike's talking about time crafting, or he's talking about no. I mean, that changed. That's not just the way I work. Like that's the how and the what. Like there's but in terms of the way I work with others, the way I work with my teammates, the way that I work with, you know, my business, Dig2Fly kind of pushed me in that direction that I didn't even know I had to go in. So can you kind of touch on like what you had to do with me initially to kind of get me to where I'm now, you know, extolling the virtues of this framework?
Yeah, I think Brené Brown describes it well as we put armor around ourselves. We, especially leaders, they want to have the answers. They want to be able to make great choices and decisions all day long. But the reality is that's not how a well-run business works. It's a collaborative effort. It's saying, you know what, I don't know what to do here. Or, you know what, I'm struggling a little bit, and this is why I'm struggling. And then the people that you work with have that context, have a little understanding of where you're coming from, and vice versa. And same with them. Like, you want them to pull away their armor, them to say, yeah, this doesn't really line up with my strengths. Those conversations at first can be difficult, but as you start to peel away those layers and you start to have those honest conversations, like we said in the Dig2Fly method, you know, it's a step-by-step framework, but the idea is you dig deep, you understand the person, they understand you better, but you don't stay there. You don't stay in the deep part, in the muck. You come out, and then the idea is you test out these ideas. You allow people to have these freedoms and try different opportunities and fail at them. That's a key part. Is I know I struggled with failure for so long. Like, I wanted to make the perfect choices, and I wanted my assistants to, know that, you know, they're working with somebody super smart. And I have that complex of feeling stupid because I do a lot of dumb shit.
You and me both, man. You and me both.
I try to cover it up, and then I'm like, no, just own it, be honest, share, be vulnerable. And it's really helped with my leadership. And once I've done that, like, everything got easier.
You speak of Brené Brown, and I've been paying a lot of attention to her work more and more lately. She had James Clear on her podcast, and it was a two-parter, but one of the things that, you know, and I know I've talked to James before about this, and I think this is apt and why Dig2Fly to me was so profound, is you don't rise to the level of your goals, you fall to the level of your systems. So I think for somebody who's sitting back here going, you know what, Mike, this is great, I don't have time for this. It's like, yeah, this is all well and good. If you follow my work for a while, you know that I'm like, that's a load of crap. You know that taking 10 seconds, 30 seconds to be thoughtful and deliberate is going to pay off in the long run. And like you said, Karl, this, like, it's not like you're sitting here going, this is a one and done proposition. And it's not like it's, you have to sit for hours and do this. You and I didn't take much time in terms of, like, it wasn't like we sat for a day and did all this. You could do that, I guess, but most of us don't have time. Like, it was something that was, you know, it was bit by bit, step by step, right?
Yeah. Yeah. I think we did yours in maybe about 50 minutes. And everybody's different. You know, some people I just did a session right before I hopped on here, and he's the owner of home repair stores in the Pennsylvania area, and he's struggling with this product called hardscaping, and it's basically like retaining walls. It's a lost leader for him, and he's struggling because he's like, do I just cut it off and stop doing it, or do I put more energy into it? And we went through the method, and this is what's really important, and what I think a lot of people need to be able, and maybe they should write this down, is as you are asking yourself these questions and digging a little deeper, you have to listen to the other person, listen to their voice inflection. What's really powerful is telling the story back to people so they can process it. They have that 50,000 foot view of where they're at and where they're stuck inside this situation. And when they can pull out, like anything, like that time and space of things, of like, you know, you have a argument with a coworker or even a family member, and then you cool off and you have that next day to think about it. that's what this does, is it gives you that 50,000 foot view to say, oh, I see where I've been stuck on this. And this is our next steps.
Hey, Karl, this has been great. Thanks so much. I mean, I don't put this stuff out here unless I know that people are going to be all over it. And I got to say, like I said, this is something that's changed the way I operate. So thanks for putting this together. Thanks for making the dig to fly method. I know how challenging it can be to like craft a framework, a system, one that has results in a fashion that allows you to, you know, number one, it's objective in the way it's framed, but subjective in the way people approach it. So that's not an easy thing to do. But the best part is that it's, once you're like developing it, may not have been easy, but when you're in it, there's a simplicity to it that I think cannot be overstated, right? Like the fact of the matter is that people that when they get into dig to fly, I think they're going to see the benefits of it. So thanks for taking the time today, buddy, to be with me. I really appreciate it.
Sure. Can I offer somebody something if they reach out to me?
You can offer whatever you want. Go ahead.
So I do this thing called the spotlight value. And the idea is, it's a big part of understanding our personality is the values that we bring. What do we value? That's one of the things that we go through is the spotlight value. And I think that's a really good way to, you know, understand how this method starts to work and how you start navigating your own life. So the first person that reaches out to me, I will do a free spotlight value session with them.
Well, leave a comment too below if you like that. Yeah, put it.
Oh, yes. Like yeah. There you go.
So the first person to comment, you know, we can reach out to you and so on and so forth.
Probably a random draw. Sure. Yeah, let's do that.
There we go. We've got it covered. And again, if you want to just check out, you've got the rate your day option too, right? So like, let's make sure people can go there. Where can people go to do that if they want to do that as well?
Just on the homepage, digtofly.com. And then I have a little sign up there and they can get the rate your day printable and they sign up and instantly they'll get the PDF.
Perfect. All right. Awesome. Karl, thanks for taking the time, buddy.
Really, thank you.
All right.
Yeah, cheers. Same here.